Digital investors, what's going on? Welcome back to another video where we go over everything that is going on inside of the crypto space. Hope you guys have all been doing well since we last spoke. We have some good news to go over from Cardano to zilliqa. We have some really bullish stuff to about Ethereum, even JP Morgan giving over some reasons why they think that Ethereum could outperform Bitcoin. We've been seeing the bullish sentiment around Ethereum start to rise. So we're going to cover mainly on this video, Ethereum, zilliqa, and Cardano. If you guys could do me a huge favor, if you're a frequent viewer of the show and you want to show the show some support, then tap the like button. It helps a ton for the YouTube algorithm to help push this video to more people. Also keep in mind, link in the description to my Crypto Clips channel. If you like short to the point videos on specific cryptocurrency topics, then make sure you go and check this out. I take the most important segments from our main videos, like the one you're watching right now, and I put the most important segments and clips up on that channel, the Crypto Clips channel. Again, the link will be in the description. And with that said, I want to hop right into it. So JP Morgan points out the difference between Ether and Bitcoin as it pertains to this study. Now, surprisingly, guys, this is actually bullish for Ethereum, right? They think it's going to outperform Bitcoin. They're not going to, you know, they're not going to be firing any employees that they find trading Ethereum. Rather, they are bullish on Ethereum. So they say Bitcoin is much more a commodity than a currency at this juncture, competing with gold as a store of value. On the flip side, Ethereum is the backbone of the cryptocurrency economy and serves as an exchange medium. They say to the extent owning a share of this Ether's potential activity is more valuable, the theory goes Ether should outperform Bitcoin over the long run. As a consequence, a higher proportion of Ether tokens behave as if highly liquid than Bitcoin, 11% versus 4%, by some estimates over the past month. In a market with significantly higher spot turnover, it is plausible that the underlying base of long exposure is less reliant on leverage in the form of futures and swaps. In response to the grand divide between the two cryptos this month, JP Morgan has released their thoughts on why this occurred and provided three main reasons for the shift. And they're mainly talking about, you know, with the market pullback that we have had. In JP Morgan's opinion, Ethereum has been much less affected than Bitcoin, again, according to them. So these are the three main reasons they say for Ethereum's resiliency. Last week, the crypto industry was hit hard by a liquidity shock. All were affected, but Bitcoin was hit harder than most and much harder than Ethereum. Ether's resistance to these events is pegged as reason number one for Ether's ability to hang on while Bitcoin slipped. The second reason that JP Morgan points out is Ether's lack of reliance on derivatives markets to transfer or warehouse risk. They say, in a market with significantly higher spot turnover, it is plausible that the underlying base of long exposure in Ether is less reliant on leverage in the form of futures and swaps than Bitcoin. And the third and final major reason for the discrepancy in Bitcoin and ETH right now is Ether has a more durable underlying demand base. They say the Ethereum network has long been characterized by a higher pace of transactions on the public blockchain than does Bitcoin, likely due in no small part to increased activity on DeFi and other platforms, says JP Morgan. So some interesting stuff regarding JP Morgan. They think it's going to outperform Bitcoin over the long haul. I know Bitcoin maxis who probably woke up this morning and read this are probably throwing an absolute temper tantrum. I really, you know, I probably have to go on BTC Maxi Twitter and just see what is going on, because I'm sure this is a lot of people riled up. But let me know what you guys think about it. Let me know what you guys think about JP Morgan saying Ether should outperform Bitcoin over the long run. Do you guys think they're being serious, or do you think they're trying to manipulate us in some way like they have in the past? Because as we know, guys, they manipulated us a lot in 2017. Right, there was a lot of manipulation going on in 2017, trying to get you think a certain way, you know, saying this and doing something else, you know, watch my hand here, but don't watch what I do behind my back. So there was a lot of that going on. So I'm interested to see what you guys think, whether or not this should be taken serious, or whether you think this is like a puppet show. And we also have Raw Paul pinpoints Ethereum's potential to become massively dominant. Raw makes some pretty interesting points, especially when you combine them with what JP Morgan said. So a new milestone for Ethereum demonstrates the platform's ability to command the crypto and financial sectors. The European Investment Bank is launching 100 million in digital bonds on the Ethereum blockchain. The EIB, the lending arm of the European Union, is tapping Ethereum's DLT technology for the registration and settlement of the digital bonds. bonds. According to a press release from the bank, they are collaborating with Goldman Sachs, Santander, and Societe Generale. And Powell says it is a test that tacitly accepts the crypto offers before settlement, custody, and transfer for the global bond market, something I have talked about for a decade. In the end, all securities of all types will migrate across to public blockchains. Also, it just shows how massively dominant ETH currently is for use cases. The EIB will issue a series of bond tokens on the Ether blockchain, and investors will pay for the tokens using fiat currency. The bond issue will still be governed by French law, and the European Bank says the digitalization of capital markets will reduce intermediaries and fixed costs while improving market transparency and settlement speed. The Director General for Finance at the EIB said this. He says, by helping to create a framework for a new market ecosystem, the EIB believes this will bring value added for both issuers and investors while contributing to an innovative, efficient, and secure market infrastructure. So pretty crazy stuff, right? And as we know, Ethereum now doing some cool things for price. Right now sitting at $2,762. So it is on the rise. So now, is it on the rise because of all the reasons that we are reading today? Or is everybody getting bullish on Bitcoin? Bullish on Ethereum just because it is on the rise? The rise fueling all of this bullish sentiment? You know, I think they both kind of plays hand in hand with each other. And as we know, prices going up and prices going down, you know, they have different effects on people that you can get shaken not only out of a market, but you can also get shaken into a market, right? Commonly known as some FOMO. Let's take a look at what Zilliqa was doing. I was scrolling through Twitter and I found this from Zilliqa. They say, we are announcing a strategic partnership with Platon Network, the privacy-preserving AI network blockchain, marking our first step into the Chinese market. And they say, read this thread to learn more about the partnership. The thread's not that long, so we'll go through it. But as you can see, Zilliqa and Platon architecting the new world of NFTs together in China. So they say, we are jointly launching commemorative NFTs with our mascots on both Zilliqa and Platon's blockchain. More details will be released at a later date for this one-of-a-kind exclusive NFT launch. And they say, here's what you should know about Platon and their impact in China. So I don't know if you guys have ever heard of Platon before, but it's pretty new to me. So Platon is an internet infrastructure protocol that is about to launch its mainnet. The network uses its native token LAT to settle trades for data and computing power. Platon has massive projects upcoming in China. For a start, Platon is slated to power China's largest blockchain-powered smart city with WX Blockchain, who pledged $29 billion over the next decade for this project. So that's pretty crazy stuff. And I don't know if I've said this on a video before. I think I've definitely mentioned it on a Patreon video, but any type of cryptocurrency that is going to fuel something like a smart city, to me, a coin that could integrate into a smart city in whatever way, right? There's different ways that a token could do that. That would probably, you know, it would have a decent amount of utility if it's being used in smart city applications. So they say Platon has also partnered with Chinese blockchain companies such as AITOS. Other projects they're involved in include data tracking solutions for Mercedes-Benz for the used car market. And they say, how does this partnership help Zilliqa? Platon's wealth of social capital, resources, and network will allow us to connect and work with these major players as we venture forth into our journey of empowering the creator economy in the world. With our large community and commercial exposure in the Western market, Platon can gain more exposure. This mutually beneficial partnership will help bring both our technologies to the forefront of both markets. Here's to a fruitful partnership. So interesting stuff. Platon seems like a pretty cool project, right? And obviously they have some pretty cool partners, some good funding. Zilliqa and Platon. So that's pretty interesting stuff. Good news for Zilliqa. Good news for Platon. Definitely going to go and do some more research on this. Moving on, we also have PayPal crypto partner Paxos raises $300 million at $2.4 billion valuation. Pretty cool stuff. We just went over Paxos a few days ago and what they were doing. So let's go over the full rundown. Today, Paxos closed a $300 million Series D round of funding, one of the largest ever among crypto and blockchain startups. The round values the company at $2.4 billion and brings its total raised capital to more than $500 million. The announcement quickly follows Paxos Series C round in December 2020, when the New York-based startup firm raised $142 million at an undisclosed valuation. Paxos plans to spend the capital expanding its regulatory compliance infrastructure, growing its headcount, scaling its operations through increasing platform capacity, and exploring acquisition opportunities. More importantly, the firm aims to onboard 3 to 5 new customers of PayPal size, says the CEO and co-founder of Paxos. Pretty crazy stuff. They want to onboard 3 to 5 new customers of PayPal size. Okay. So think about that. I think we're going to see Paxos, become a pretty big player here, right? It seems as though they're setting themselves up for that. Paxos technology powers crypto brokerage services of PayPal and PayPal-owned Venmo, which enables millions of users to buy, hold, and sell Bitcoin and a handful of other major cryptos. The company's other products and services include a U.S. dollar-backed stablecoin called Paxos Standard, cryptocurrency exchange ITBIT, and an equity settlement service called, equities settlement service used by Credit Suisse. Additionally, on April 23rd, the company received conditional approval of the de novo trust bank charter for digital assets from the Office of the Comptroller of the Currency. Paxos seeks to become the first digital asset custodian regulated at both the state and federal levels. The OCC charter will also let Paxos to hold money directly with the Federal Reserve and thus hold and move customers' cash more efficiently, okay? Pretty interesting stuff. The charter will let Paxos hold money directly with the Federal Reserve. And we also have Paxos applying for a clearing agency license with the U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission following a successful pilot test in which Credit Suisse and Istanet used Paxos to execute trades on the same day settlement cycle known as T+O. But Paxos does not want to simply tokenize equities. They are also eyeing opportunities to apply the blockchain technology to unregistered securities, private company shares, and other types of investment products. So really, really cool stuff for Paxos. Got another round of funding, $300 million, $2.4 billion valuation. As we can see, they're working on some pretty interesting stuff, have some pretty interesting partners. I think we're going to see them be a very strong player in the crypto space. And we also have Cardano to roll out blockchain-based IDs to millions of students in Africa. So this is pretty crazy. IOHK is announcing a partnership with the Ethiopian government aimed at digitizing the country's education sector. IOHK's Director for African Operations, John O'Connor, says that the blockchain firm will deploy its decentralized identity solution, Prism, to thousands of schools in Africa's second most populous country. The identity solution will be used to digitally verify grades, remotely monitor school performance, and boost education and employment across Ethiopia. They say this will provide all students with blockchain-verified digital qualifications to reduce fraudulent university and job applications and increase social mobility by allowing employers to verify all applicants' grades without third-party agencies. The partnership between IOHK and the Ethiopian government will initially benefit 3,500 schools, 5 million students, and 750,000 teachers. The project could ultimately be extended to universities where degrees are also digitally verified on the Cardano blockchain, allowing employers to easily validate the authenticity of applicants' educational credentials, which I hear is a pretty big problem right now, people faking their education. So if an employer can, validate it on something trustless like a blockchain, validate the applicant's education, that could be very good. So earlier this month, IOHK founder Charles Hoskinson hinted at upcoming business opportunities in Africa. And this is what they said. They say, we're also on the commercial side, really scaling up our commercial division. And in Africa in particular, we're definitely going to scale up resources there into the 8 figures because there's a lot of good news coming. So that's what they hinted at. This is the good news that seems to be coming. Really, really crazy stuff for Cardano, for all of them today, right? From Ethereum to Zilliqa to Cardano. Some really good news for all of them. Our price for today, we have Bitcoin at 53,000. Ethereum, as we know, is at 2,700. XRP at $1.39. Binance Coin at 589. Cardano at $1.35. Dogecoin at 30 cents. Polkadot at $33. Uniswap at $40. And Litecoin at $254. And this is video number 233. It is crazy to think that there have been over, because I know I have a few videos. When I make these videos, guys, I title them just by number. Like in my files, they're all by number. So each time I record a new video, I just up the number one. So today we're on 233, and I have some that I made that I wasn't using numbers. I had to put like alternate titles, so I know we're over that. But it's really crazy to have over 230 uploads out right now. We also have our fear and greed index sitting at 52. We were in fear before, but now we're in 52. Yesterday we were in greed at 59. So it looks like we got that nice sentiment reset. Maybe we'll push into fear again, really reset it. But so far, you know, this could be what we needed. We went into fear. We had the sentiment reset. We definitely had a shakeout. Retail was definitely scared. You know, some confidence returning now. Maybe we'll go for another leg lower. You know, who really knows what's going to happen in the short term? I don't try to, you know, concern myself too much with what is happening in the short term and short term price movements, but it is really nice to see that we, you know, went all the way down to fear, reset the sentiment. Now we're back in neutral. We'll see if prices start to increase and we start pushing greed again, or if we continue to reset this fear and greed index. And with that said, guys, that is the video for today. If you enjoyed it, tap the like button. It really helps a ton to help me grow the channel and get this video out to more people. I appreciate all the support that you guys have shown. We are at over 21,000 subscribers, so that is amazing. The next goal is 25,000, so let's see if we can hit that by the end of next month. And with that said, guys, keep in mind, this is not financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor. I'm just documenting the daily crypto news and this crypto bull run. And with that said, I will see you all on the next one. Have a great day, everybody.